Hi guys, and welcome to another video. In today's lesson, we're going to make this awesome bag. This bag can be made in various sizes. I've made my one quite large. This would fit two adult size towels in there for the beach. But you could use this as a project bag and also a shopping bag. But it can be easily made smaller, and I'll show you how in the video. There will be a free written pattern to this, and the links are in the description box. So let's get started on the lesson. I would like to say thank you to Redheart for providing the yarn for this project. For yarn and lots of free patterns, check out redheart.com. This yarn is Redheart with Love, and I'd like to say a huge thank you to Redheart for supplying the yarn for this video tutorial. Like I said, it is a worsted weight yarn that's also a 10 ply, and this project would also work great with Redheart Super Saver. And I think if you wanted to use an 8 ply or a double knit yarn, the Redheart Shimmer or Redheart Soft is about the same thickness of that, and I think the shimmer would look absolutely amazing in this. You will also need 4 stitch markers. So grab your yarn that you want to use for... You cannot see me behind this camera, I'm in knots at the moment. Oh dear. Right, here we go. We are going to grab the colour that we want to use for the base of our bag, and we're just going to make a slip knot. We can do this any way you want to. And the first row is worked slightly different than the rest of the bag. So if you've made a granny square before, you'll know that you put 3 stitches into the one space, but on the first row of this, it's worked just a little slightly different, but then the rest of the bag is worked like that. So we're going to chain multiples of 4. So this means that you do 4 chain. Is your bag wide enough? No. So we go again. 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, it's not wide enough, so keep going. And I'm going to chain 36 altogether. So I'm going to do that off camera, and I'll meet you back and I'll have 36 stitches. Altogether I have 40 chains. Sorry, I looked at my chain and I thought it was a bit short, so I just added 4 more onto that. So I've got 40 chains, and now what I want to do is half double crochet into the 5th chain from the hook. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it's yarning over, go into the stitch, yarn over, pull up a loop, and yarn over and pull through all 3. And we're going to do a half double crochet in the next 2 chains. So yarning over, going into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through all 3. We're going to chain 1, we're going to skip a stitch, so we're skipping that one, and into the next 3 chains we're going to work 1 half double crochet. So skip 1 in the next one, and we're going to repeat this across. We're going to chain 1, we're going to skip a chain, and in the next 3 chains we're going to work 1 half double crochet. Oops, I keep going to do a double crochet. I've already filmed this twice because I kept doing double crochet. We're going to chain 1, skip 1, and 1 half double crochet, oops, in the next 3 stitches. So we're going to repeat this all the way across. So it's chain one, skip one, and one half double crochet in the next three chains. When we get to the last chain, we won't, you'll think you won't have enough, but just go as far as you can go with that, because in the last chain we work, I'm just checking the pattern, we just work one stitch, not the three. So that's what it looks like so far. You've got your chain one spaces there, and then you've got a chain one space here, and then you've got, it's just the chains, but it's the stitch on the end. So repeat that across, and I'll meet you when we are up to the end. So when we get to the ends, we've got these stitches left over, and you think, it's not going to fit. But that's because it doesn't fit. So what we're going to do, we're going to chain one. So I've just done my three half double crochet, chain one, skip one, and then one half double crochet in the last stitch. And what that's done has just mirror imaged the other end. So you've got chain one and then one space, one stitch. And then here you've got just a bunch of chains from the beginning, but that's the first hole. And then the last hole, they look the same. So that's round one. So round two, we're going to chain two. We haven't turned or anything. We're just going to chain two. And from now on, this pattern is worked in the round. Half double crochet into the space at the end of row one. In the written pattern, there's pictures for you, but I can show you on the video. So half double crochet in the space at the end of round one. So see here, we've got our half double crochet and there's our chain one space. If you like, you can just turn it around so it's facing that way. And we're going to crochet into here. We're going to work two half double crochet into that space. We're going to chain one and then work three half double crochet in the same space. Now in our end spaces, we are going to have three groups of three half double crochets, but we're going to put the other one in when we come back around. So we're going to work basically the last part of this row. Round. So now what we're going to do, into these chain one spaces, we're going to work three half double crochets. So we're going to do chain one, and find the next chain one space from the previous row, which is here, and in there we're going to work three half double crochet. One, two, and three. Chain one into the next chain one space, again work three half double crochet. So I'm going to stop saying half double crochet now, because it's basically worked in the same stitch until we get to the top of the bag. So chain one into the next chain one space, we're going to work three stitches. And we're going to repeat this, we're going to repeat this all the way across. So what have I got? I've got two. So repeat that all the way across, doing a chain one. Next chain one space, work three half double crochets, and pause the video and I'll meet you at the end of this row, which will actually be just over here, and I'll show you what to do at the end. Sorry, it's not the end of the row, it's the end of this side of the bag. Okay, so pause the video, see you in a sec. So when we get to the end, we have our space here, and we've got a chain one up there, so I've already done that. So we're going to do three half double crochet into the end space. We're going to chain one, work three more half double crochet in that space. Oh, I said I wasn't going to say half double crochet anymore. Whoops. Sorry. Chain one, and then three more stitches into that same space. And that is our corner piece made. It's a little squished up there, but when we come back around, we're just going to work into the chain one spaces, and that will be good. And so now we're working down the other side, and we're just going to repeat what we did on the other side. So we did a chain one, and then three half double crochet in the chain one space. Chain one, again, next space here, three half double crochet. Oops, it's happening. Chain one, three half double crochet in the next. It is a chain one space because we remember how we skipped. It's just. I speak good English. We skipped a chain one. We skipped a chain on the first row. Remember how we skipped a chain? Well, this is where we're going into now. So it is literally a chain one space. May as well just keep the camera going until we get up to the end. I'm just going to speed up. So make sure you share what yarn you're using and the crochet hook that you're using, and also colours that you're going to use. I love to hear about what people have planned. It's really good. And also tag me on Instagram with any progress photos, and also share them on Facebook. Okay, I think that's right. I always just have a quick look back at my work. Looks good. So we are... Oh, sorry guys. I'm going to take that last bit out. I've gone one step ahead of myself. So when we get to the end, here is the end chain one space. So we worked our two groups of half double crochets there. So then we're going to yarn over and we're going to work three stitches into that last space. And that completes the three sets of stitches. So we've got one, two, three. And that just so that last one there completes the last set. So we've got our chain one, and we're going to join to the first stitch. So there we go. I'm going to change colour now. If you don't want to change colour, what you're going to do is slip stitch. So I'll show you what to do. You're not changing colour, so you're staying with the colour you've got. You're going to slip stitch into the top of the next lot of stitches until you get to the chain one space, and you're going to slip stitch into there, and then you're ready for the next round. I'm not going to do that because I'm going to change color, so I'm going to pull those slip stitches out, not the one where we joined, just the ones in the tops of the stitches there, and I'm going to cut my yarn and finish off, and I'm actually going to join my new color into the chain one space. And then that way, we are both going to be in the same spot. I'm just organising my yarn as I'm talking. We are going to be in the same spot. Everyone's going to be in the same spot in the pattern, no matter if you change colour or not. So I'm going to grab the green for my next colour. I do this quite quick in videos when I change colour, but I'm literally just grabbing my yarn, putting it over my finger, and I just pinch it. Just pinch the yarn. Sometimes people think it's something fancy, but it's really not. Put it onto my crochet hook. I take my finger out and I just sort of flip it backwards so that it's nice and tight up there, and just pull it through. That's really all I've done. I'm sure we've all got different ways, but that's just how I do it. And then I do a chain and then pull on the short green. just to secure it into there. And then we can sew in our towel later, so I'll pop that at the back. So we are now up to the corner. This is the corner of our bag, and this is where we're going to do our increasing to get it to... If we don't do increasing now, it's literally going to be a straight up and down bag. It won't have any sort of volume to the base of the bag. So what we need to do is increase in this chain one space and this chain one space. Let's see. You know what? If you want a bit more volume, we're going to increase in this chain one space and that chain one space as well. So I'm going to get a stitch marker. This is just to remind me in the video that when I get to that one, we're going to do increasing. So you won't need your stitch marker because you're either having a ribbon pattern or you're going to follow along. I mean, sure, you can do it too if it's going to remind you. Okay, so grabbing our new colour, we're going to chain two. Jeez, more thumbs. And we're going to work three stitches into our chain one space where our yarn is joined. So one, that's two. So we've got our chain two counts as our first stitch, then we've got two more. We're going to chain one, and we're going to work three stitches back into that same space. One, two, and three. Into the next space, we're going to work three half double crochet, chain one, and three half double crochet, and this is our increase in this pattern. So it's like a corner on a granny square, except I'm using half double crochet instead. So three stitches, chain one, and three stitches in the chain one spaces across, apart from the very last one. You've got your corner there, but that one there, we're going to do an increase in that one. So in the next, if you've got the same amount of chains, it'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. In those spaces, we are just going to do three half double crochet and a chain one. Oh, my stitch markers are tapping. It's annoying. Let's see if that will fix it. Probably not. So in the next one, three half double crochet. I'm trying to lift it up, but now it's going out of the camera. Chain one, and repeat this across until we get to that second last chain one space. So pause the video and I'll meet you there. So now we have, so I'm up to here, and we've got a chain one space there, and then two in the corner, and a chain one space there. So in the next four chain one spaces, so 1, 2, 3, 4, we're going to work an increase. So I can get rid of these stitch markers. They're out of there. And we're going to work an increase, so it's three stitches. Chain one, and three stitches in the same chain one space. Chain one. Into the next chain one space, we're going to do the exact same thing. So three stitches. I'm just grabbing some yarn. It's coming to the end of the ball, so it's not feeding out very well. chain one and three more stitches. Into the next chain one space, again, do the same thing. Three stitches, chain one, three stitches. Chain one, and into the next chain one space, we're going to do the same thing again. So we should have four lots of increasing on the end of the piece of work that we've got at the moment. So you've got, so that's just a normal shell. You've got an increase, 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 increase. So now all the way across, and not the last space or the second last chain one space, because that's where our increases are going to go. We're just going to work our way across doing just, you probably already know, but I'll just quickly show you. I'm getting tied up today. Into the next space, it's just three stitches and a chain one. If you accidentally forget to do your chain one, please don't panic. It's really not going to make a difference, because when we put in our three stitches, it kind of stretches, not stretches, but kind of spaces out the stitches here. So if you forget a chain one, and you, it doesn't really matter. It's not, you're really not going to notice it. Just making sure I did a chain one there. You're really not going to notice it. So don't think, if you get all the way around, you've got to rip that row out. Unless you can't handle it being like that, then by all means rip it out. But if it doesn't worry you, and you've only done like one, and you've missed one out, don't worry about it. So work across, pause the video, and I'll see you at the end. So when we get to the end, we've got our chain one space here and the last chain one space there. So if I hold it up like that, it might be a bit easier to see. Chain one space here and here. And remember how we have four increases on the end? We've already got two that we started on the first part. So now we've just got to finish off the other ones. So grab, if you've got a stitch marker in there, just grab that out and finish with that little guy. Or girl. Doesn't really matter, because there's stitch markers and they're plastic. Oh god, I got crazy today. Why? I know why. I'm excited. My friend is coming to stay with me through a week, and she gets here this afternoon. So if I'm a bit all over the place, that's why. I'm really excited. So it's three stitches, chain one, and three stitches in that same chain one space. And I also get to have a week off work, which is why I'm madly trying to get this video done. This will be the project that I'm working on while she's here. So we've got three stitches, chain one, three stitches, chain one, into the next chain one space, which will be our last one. We are going to work an increase. If you want, if you change colours, you're going to have that tail there. I'm actually going to flip it back this way. I can just work over it slightly there, if it will stay in place. So we're going to put our increase in there. So yeah, I get a week off work. Yippee! Which is a big deal to me, because I work very hard. So chain one and three stitches back in the same chain one space. And that completes the last increase for this round. And tomorrow we're going yarn shopping. My friend knits and crochets, so you could just imagine the fun we're going to have. So you should have four on the end. So one, two, three, four increases. So chain one into the first stitch where it's here. I'm going to join. Well, I carry on with this green and just do the next round and then change colours. I don't want to change colours too many times, because that will be a lot of ends. So if you're changing colours, finish off and join your colour in the next chain one space. If you're not changing colours like me, you are going to slip stitch across. So you're going to find the next stitch. Don't work your slip stitches tight because it will pull the work across and you don't want that to happen. So all the way over to the chain one space, I'm also working a slip stitch into there, and that just makes it so our yarn's in the right place to start. So now what we're going to do, I'm going to put in again stitch markers to remind me. When we come back around, there's an increase going in there. And this round is the last increase round. If you don't want your bags so, what did I say before, like a lot of volume at the bottom, then don't do any increases on this round and just do 3 stitches in each stitch. So I'm also going to put one there, that's to remind me to do the other increase. I haven't actually written up this part of the pattern, that's why I'm using these to remind me, because I'm not actually following anything as normal. So yeah, if you don't want any bigger on the bottom, if you don't want as big as the one in the pattern, you can just stop increasing now. So when I'm doing my increases, you just do 3 stitches in the same space instead of the increase. So everything else, apart from these end stitches here, are just a normal 3 stitch. So chain 2 stitches in the same space, chain 1. In the next chain 1 space, I'm going to work 3 stitches, chain 1. In the next chain 1 space, we're going to work 3 stitches, chain 1. And all the way across, in every chain 1 space, you're going to just work 3 stitches and a chain 1. And you're going to come to here and you can put one in there and in there and in there. And then I'll meet you when we are up to this end part here. So pause the video and I'll see you then. So I've worked my way across and I'm up to this chain 1 space here. And it's the only, well it isn't, no sorry, it's the middle chain 1 space on this flat edge on the end. So into that one we're going to work an increase. So it's your 3 stitches, chain 1 and 3 stitches. 1, 2, 3, chain 1 into the next space. You can work 3 stitches. Chain 1. And now we're just going to work down the other side, down this way. And we're just going to do 3 stitches in each, 3 stitches in a chain 1 in each chain 1 space. And I'll meet you when we're up to the next stitch marker, which is on the end here. So pause the video and I'll see you there. I am up to my end here and I'm just going to take that stitch marker out and just put it to the side. And in this space here, in the chain 1 space, we're going to work an increase. And this is the last increase that we do for this pattern. So it's 3 stitches, chain 1 and 3 stitches. Two, three, chain 1, and then we're going to join to the very first stitch. And I'm going to finish off my colour here. I would recommend sewing in your ends. I'm totally not going to do this because I just know what I'm like. Sew your ends in after, you know, 5 or so rounds. So when you get to the end, I'm just grabbing more yarn. When you get to the end, you don't have heaps of ends to sew in, because I know that's why people hate sewing them in. So if you do a couple at a time, it's not going to feel so much of a mission when you get to the end. So now I'm going to join in a new colour. Oh. Oh yeah, no, I'm doing it right. Aren't I? How long have I been crocheting for? That would be about 15 years. So we're going to join in a new colour. And now I am going to do one. So a shell. I don't know if I've mentioned a shell yet, but it's just one group of three. So chain two and two half double crochet, because your chain two counts as your first stitch. Chain one into the next space. That's a chain one space. We're going to work three stitches and a chain one. And we're going to repeat this all the way around. And we repeat this row for the for the remainder of the project. And then we will add our handles and things on. I haven't decided how I want mine to look yet, so I've got the next week to think about it, because that's when I'll be stitching this up. Okay. So yeah, like I said, it's just literally three stitches and a chain one in every chain one space around, and then you'll come here and join, and you're just going to repeat that the whole way around. And gradually, at the moment it doesn't look like it because it's reasonably flat, but gradually the sides of the bag will start to form, because now we're not doing any more increasing. So if you do increasing on the edges, it will lay flat. But if you don't do any increasing, it'll start to curve up and go up straight. And that's what we want it to do, because we want a bag. If we keep increasing, it's probably not going to look like a bag, more like a pancake. So I will see you in the next part of the video. So I finished the main section of my bag and I have 35 rounds all together. So that's right from the bottom all the way, so down where the pink is here, all the way to the top is 35 rounds. So now we're ready to put our handles on. And what we're going to do first is we're going to make a band around the top, so that we've got something for our handles to attach to. That just finishes it off nicely. So the next part in the video, we are going to just put the band on and then we'll be onto the handles. We're going to lay our bag flat, so you can see that it's still flat from how it was just sitting on the floor. And we're going to attach it to any of the sides. So we can attach it over here, or we can attach it over there. I'm going to attach it over the other side because we've got all these ends on this side and it's going to get in the way. So just grabbing your yarn, and I'm using the yellow, which, what was it called? It's called Daffodil, and this is the Red Heart with Love. And you're not going to be able to tell in this video, but it's actually been about 6 weeks since I was last filming. So the last part before this bit started, like just before I said I'd finish my bag, was 6 weeks ago. Crazy times. So what we're going to do is I'm going to zoom in just slightly, and it almost feels a bit foreign sitting here, to tell you the truth. We're going to join in our yarn. I'm using my yellow because that is the most that I have left. I know I just started talking about the yellow, but I think I may have got sidetracked. But that's the most I've got left, so I'm going to start with my yellow, and we're just going to join it in there. Doesn't matter which stitch you join it into, just anywhere on the side of our bag. And I'm going to single crochet in the same stitch. Now you can continue on with a double crochet. you could do a half double crochet, but I'm choosing the single crochet. I think it looks nice with the band. It gives it more of a, I just like the way the single crochet looks. So in every stitch around, you know what, I can't even remember what I did with this bag on the pattern. Did we do a chain one? Yes, we did. Right, so we are doing a single crochet into the chain one and also into each stitch. My pattern is still hanging up to the side of me, which is exactly where I left it 6 weeks ago. I think it's actually been more than that. When am I holiday? When do I catch the plane? I think it was the 4th of May, and it's now about the 16th of June. Yep. So, single crochet all the way around. If you want to make the top of your bag sort of a lot smaller, like the opening of your bag a lot smaller than the width of the actual bag section, what you could do is skip the chain one and just single crochet in the three stitches, like 1, 2, 3, and then skip the chain one. It's up to you, but I'm just going to single crochet in each stitch all the way around, and I'll meet you when we get back to here. When we get back to the other side, what we're going to do is we're going to join with a slip stitch to the very first single crochet. You could work in a spiral if you choose, which means that you don't join and you just single crochet in the top of that first stitch. But I'm not going to do that. We're going to chain one and we're going to go back into the same stitch and we're going to work a single crochet. The chain one doesn't count as a stitch, it's just to get us to the height that we need to be at for the single crochet. And the next part of the pattern, you can do as many rounds as you like, pretty much. I'm probably going to do, I would say, between 3 and 5 rounds. I just want to sort of make a little band. My handles aren't going to be chunky, so I don't really want my band to be chunky. And I do have other handles that you can use for bags. I've got a couple of market bags, which has got, one's got 2 straps, which pretty much is what we're going to do for this one. And then the other one's got 1 strap. So I'll put links to that in the description box for you for those other videos. And you can adapt that handle to this bag. It's worked the same. You single crochet or you may half double crochet around the top of the bag. And then you add the handle. So all you've got to do is follow from where the band starts and continue on. If I forget to add that link, just leave a comment in the comment section. Please add the link for the other bag handles and I will put it in. Hopefully I remember. So we're going to single crochet all the way around and then we're going to come back and we're going to join and we're going to repeat this round that we've just done until we've got as many rounds as we have would like. So like I said, I'm going to do between 3 and 5. You want to grab your stitch markers and you've got the top of your bag. My yarn's just attached over here where I finished. I've done 4 rounds altogether. To make our handles, what we're going to do is we're going to fold our bag in half and then you're going to fold this end back that way. We're just working out where to put our handles. So you're going to fold in half and then fold that back into the middle. And just here is where we're going to put our stitch marker, because we're finding the quarter waypoint. We'll put one in the front and then also one in the back. And then, sorry, not the one in the back. We don't need that one yet. What we're going to do is count from the corner, or sorry, the edge, across to the stitch marker. So we've got, including the one that I've marked, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 stitches. You're going to go to the other side of your work, and you're going to count 17 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. And you're going to put your stitch marker in that stitch there. You're going to go over to the other side of your bag, and just make sure that your bag is laying flat. You're going to go from the edge and count 17 stitches in on the front, and also 17 stitches in on the back. Now these stitch markers are going to help us placing our handles onto our bag. So altogether you're going to have 4 stitch markers, 2 on the front and 2 on the back. I'm hoping you can see that a little bit better.
So my yarn is attached over here still, and that's the beginning of the round. And we're just going to single crochet until we get to our stitch marker. So I'm just going to turn the camera off and I'll meet you when we're at our very first stitch marker. So I'm up to my stitch marker, which is over here, and my next stitch marker is here. And what we're going to do is count how many stitches are between here and there. So I'm going to do that now. So in between my stitch markers, it is by sheer fluke that I have 30 stitches. And what we're going to do is we're going to times that by 3. So whatever your number is, so not the stitches that we've marked, but the stitches in between that, we're going to times however many there are by 3. So mine's 30. So I need to make 3, 6, 9. I need to make 90 chains altogether. But you can adjust your handle to really any size that you want to do. If you want to make your handles just little short ones that you just want to hold with your hand, so just like a handle that you just want to grab hold like that, if you want to do that, you're going to need to move your stitch markers in closer together, because at this distance at the moment, that's going to be about 20 centimeters or about 10 inches. I think that's going to be too wide for just little handles. So if you wanted to do smaller ones, you're going to need to move your stitch markers in a bit. And don't forget to move your back ones if you're doing that as well. So now I'm going to I'm going to tell you the truth. There's actually 29 stitches. But it was easier for me to times 30 by 3. But if that doesn't matter. Like, it doesn't matter on the amount of chains that you do. So if 30 is easier for you to times by 3, that I just couldn't work out 3 times 29 very quick. So, and I haven't got a calculator near me. Yeah, so 90 stitches. So I'm going to do 90 chains off camera, and then I'm going to come back, and then we're going to join it over here. So I've done my 90 chains, and I've got my yarn stuck. Keep it real, people. Keep it real. So where we've marked the next one, so this is stitch marker number 2. We're going to take that out. Ooh, matchy matchy. And then we're going to go into the marked stitch, and we're just going to do a single crochet. And now, you can't really see this properly on the camera, but I have a handle. Of course we're going to crochet around it, but that's the start of the handle. So I'm just going to move that stitch marker out the way. Now what we're going to do is single crochet around until we get to the next stitch marker around the other side. So single crochet around. So I'm around to my third stitch marker. I'm going to take that out, and I've single crocheted into the marked stitch. I'm going to do my chain. So that was 90. You may have a different amount, but that's completely fine. You're going to do your 90 chains. So I'm going to do that off camera, and I'll meet you after we have our chains. And we're going to go around to our fourth stitch marker. I'm going to take that out. And we're going to single crochet into that marked stitch. And now we're going to single crochet around, and we've only got to join a single crochet across to our join. So continue on, and I will see you when we are ready to... Actually, I won't see you when we're ready to join. I'm going to get you to join. You know how to do that. And then we're going to single crochet. So I'm here. I've got a single crochet and join. Single crochet, la la la. Until we get to our handles over here, and you can remove that stitch marker if you want to. So across and join, and then single crochet across. I'll meet you at the handles. So I've crocheted across to my handles, and now what we're going to do is put one single crochet into every chain around. So I'm going to see if I can work under two loops. That will give it a nicer finish. If we go through one loop, we'll show you what happens. Go through one loop, it pulls up a big hole. I don't know if you can see that properly. Pulls up a big hole there, and it doesn't look very nice. So if you get two loops, one at the front and one at the back, like when you're going to crochet normally, and then go and do your single crochet. It takes a little bit longer to get both loops, but it looks nicer, I think. So we're going to continue all the way around our handle. Wee, good, it's a long handle. All the way along our handle, and I'll meet you when we're at the other side of our handle over here. So when we get around here, I've just done my chain. I'm going to go into the first single crochet there, and I'm just doing a single crochet, and then we're going to single crochet around. When you get to your handle on the other side, you're just going to do exactly the same as what you did here, and then crochet around, and then you're going to join. And then after that, we're going to work two more rounds of single crochet. When you get to the handles, it's going to be easy, because as you come along here, as you come along here with your single crochet, you're just going to keep going past the handle, and it will just be a smooth transition all the way around. So I'm going to complete this round, and then I'm going to add two more rounds, and that means the handles will have three rounds altogether. Of course, you can add as many as you like. I've done three rounds, so you've got three rounds on the handles, and I've just joined at the end of my round. And I'm just going to finish off, cut about 2 to 3 inches of yarn, so you've got enough to sew in. And then just pull that tight, and then we're just going to sew in our ends. So here is my finished bag. I do need to sew in all my ends, but I've just quickly got that to show you. I love this bag, I really love it. I love how it's come out. It's going to be huge, it's going to fit lots of stuff in it, and perfect for the beach. You can fit, well, easily 2 adult size beach towels in that one, plus all the stuff that you need. So, oh, it'll also make an awesome project bag, definitely for a blanket. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Please give it the thumbs up if you like the video. Share it with your friends. Leave a comment below what colors you're going to be using for your project. Please tag me on Instagram if you're over there, and also on our Facebook page. I'm also on Patreon now, and if you would like to support me over there, I would really, really appreciate it. All the links that I've spoken about in this video are in the description box. It's usually below or to the side of the video. Thanks for watching, and until next time, happy crochet!